Houston. Beverly and Harden man the back. Smith out there with help.
Clark, that is just ridiculous.
Absolutely filthy. Oh, I don't remember ever seeing a dunk like that in the game. He certainly didn't see it the last time I saw it.
Oh, man, that was just amazing. Well, James Harden is a pure scorer. And to get this Rockets team where they hope to go, he has to lead in more ways than just offensively. He really needs to set the example with his defense, his effort, and his unselfishness.
Griffin. Right side, Griffin. Back to Paul. You know what? So Houston will take it the other way. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sideline.
Guys, I caught up with Doc Rivers for a minute. A lot of his strategy is focused on Dwight Howard, and rightly so. He said, we know Dwight can do it all, and he's going to take a five-man effort to slow him down.
That story, Doris. Ariza against Barnes. Al Harden deflects the pass. Smith. Jordan with the rebound. Howard against Barnes. And then Griffin with the dunk.
Tell you what, he's not an easy guy to stop when he's got his sight on the rim.
Never has been, never will be. A determined finisher.
And I love how he goes with that one-hand tomahawk slam. Beautiful.
From deep, Harden. That's good. Harden's got 7 points.
It's going to be tough for the defense today. If he's got his A-game rolling here tonight, we'll see.
Paul goes in to the wing on the left. Redick inside the line. Dwight Howard pulls it in. The Rockets have gone 3-5, shooting the ball so far. Harden kicks to Howard. Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession.
Such a careless pass. You've got to keep your head in the game here.
Clippers have gone 2-5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. Over in the corner, Barnes. And he gets it to go. Barnes has got his first pass. Houston in the lead. Got himself on the board with 3 there.
And a lot of times his first quarter seems to dictate how big of a role he plays later on. He's off to a good start.
A little bit of a magic act here, pulling off the Houdini to make that catch and slam.
Stupendous, stupendous alley-oop.
This crowd just stunned at the sight of that
one. Screen by Smith. Feeds it to Beverly. Kicks it to Howard. Houston moving the ball around. And play stops, whistling what looks to be an illegal screen.
Yeah, good call there. You could tell he was moving into the defender when he tried to set the screen.
Yeah, lowered that shoulder, dipped right into him, too. I mean, he was going to be called on that foul either way.
Jordan sets the pick for Paul. This is to Jordan. And James Harden with the rebound.
One of his issues is he's a player that just does not excel at fighting through contact on his way to the rim.
Pass to Howard. Back to Harden. Howard with a screen on Paul. Harden dishes to Beverly. Ariza has the open look. Second chance shot, and it's Howard laying it in.
That rebound and the follow kind of typify what he's all about. Just a pretty determined play.
Griffin. Ball passes to Redick. Now the feed to Barnes. He dishes it to Jordan. It's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
DeAndre Jordan alongside Blake Griffin, maybe the best game dunker in the league. He has the ability to make spectacular plays every time he gets near the rim.
And that one misses.
And for DeAndre Jordan Clark, between his length and his leaping ability, you almost feel like he's playing in an 11-foot, 12-foot rim.
I tell you, when I've watched him play, there are times when it seems that he's overwhelming. It really does look like that.
Looking at who's out there now for the Rockets. Adeyunas has checked in for Smith. Brewer comes in for Trevor Ariza. And it's Terry in for Patrick Beverly. 3-on-3. Here's Barnes. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
Matt Barnes, really a good blue guy. He rebounds, defends. He's got better with his outside shot. And he can really run the lane. He's always had a toughness and a fearlessness that I think a lot of coaches love.
That one drops. He ties it up. And you look at advanced plus-minus measurements, Matt Barnes rates very well.
Not surprised by that, Kevin. He brings so much energy at both.
Oh! What a play!
Oh, look at that.
That is a...
Bringing down the house! Complete disregard of human life and his own safety. Pulling a move like that.
He just can't help himself, can he? Right between the eyes, as somebody I know might say.
Dishes to Barnes. And again, it's the Clippers missing. For Houston, they've gone 6-9, shooting it well. Brewer's shot is off. Clippers have gotten 5 of 10 shots to drop in this game so far. Right at the 50% mark. Here's Jordan. And it's sent that guy home from outside the arc. And he gets the bucket. And it's 9 points for Barnes.
I like the way he's not forcing anything, taking advantage of what the defense has given him. He's been a key contributor for them in this quarter.
James Harden with the most famous beard in the NBA. In fact, he leaves his barber in terms of trimming it, so you can give him all the credit and maybe the blame.
And Harden, a relatively quiet demeanor, some have even said moody, but clearly he's embraced his new leading role in Houston.
And he says as much himself. He looks at the Rockets as his team, and you can see it in his demeanor on the court. With that leadership comes responsibility. Continue to step in. Tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
Terry in the corner. Another miss by Houston.
Well, they'll give him that shot. He doesn't have the most reliable jump shot in the world. We know that.
And the foul on Jason Terry. That is his first foul of the game. Well, the Rockets, wouldn't you say, are really to be commended, Clark, for rebuilding this team without tearing it down to the studs or tanking, if you will.
Yeah, absolutely, Kevin. I mean, they've improved dramatically with Harden and Howard. This is a team that's held a winning record in the West now for 8 straight seasons. That's pretty impressive.
It is. Kept alive. Kicks it out to Paul. He feeds it to Barnes. Paul with the ball, and it's Harden picking him up. Again, Harden. The dish to Redick. Paul for 3. No good. The Rockets go the other way with it.
And the Rockets show great patience and planning over time, freeing up cap space, acquiring young assets. That enabled them to trade for James Harden and, of course, attract Dwight Howard in free agency, too.
Jordan sets the pick for Paul. Over in the corner, Barnes. Clippers rebound. Redick with the 3. The shot no good. Rockets leading by 3. Terry kicks the Brewer. It's good. The assist that time from Harden. Harden's got 3 assists tonight.
This Rockets team, for all of its success, is still young, still developing that chemistry. But make no mistake, they've elevated themselves from playoff contender to potential title. That's exciting times, and certainly in store in Houston.
Houston's gone 2 or 3 from deep so far in this game. On the wing, Jason Terry. Pass to Howard. Back to Terry, and stolen by Redick. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. Jordan up top. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Nobody near Barnes. And he missed.
misses the go-ahead basket. The Rockets have gotten 8 of their 13 shots to find the bottom of the bucket. Brewer,
beautiful work in the transition game. That's how to do it. Attack early before the defense can get itself set.
Paul passes to Griffin. The ball. Locks up the alley-oop pass. Tries to save it. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Clipper is well retained possession. And it's a completely new group for Los Angeles. And the Rockets making a change here as well. Pablo Prigioni has checked in for James Harden. Crawford, no one around him. And again, no good by the Clipper. Rockets leading by 4. And Prigioni kicks to Brewer. Gets it from 3-point range. Brewer's got his 3rd basket of the night right there.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key. Yeah, they have the defense on the run right now because every pass seems to have a purpose of getting great movement, great spacing, and they're really lining up.
Passes it to Hawks. Crawford outside. Shoots the 3. Davis dishes to Turkoglu. And Davis can't get it to go.
Rebounding's going to be the focal point for them in this one, fella. I can feel it.
Yeah, it's a physical game, and so far the numbers show that they've got the edge on the glass.
Howard in the post. He's against Hawks. No good from Howard.
All the defender had to do there was just stay close to him, and he did.
Crawford kicks to Davis, and out of bounds as the Rockets gain possession.
Where was he going with that pass?
Has checked in for Dwight Howard. Leone passes to Brewer. That one wide left. Clippers trail by 7. Turkoglu right side. And Terry over to help. Rivers kicks to Hawk. That's good.
Great assist there. Led him to the perfect spot.
Chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for the Rockets.
A lot of success from mid-range so far for them, guys. If nothing else worked, they can always fall back on the jump shot.
And don't forget about their 3-point shooting, too, because that could be a major factor here tonight.
And it's Terry off the drive. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. And here's Crawford. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Here's Turkoglu. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2.
Great job. Taking right at the defense. I like the aggressive.
Yeah, he left him no choice but to foul there.
That free throw good from Turkoglu.
You know, every time these two teams face off, it is Battle Los Angeles. For so long, the Lakers have really owned the city. The Clippers looking to make up for lost time right now.
Catching up on the changes for Houston. Smith checked in for Brewer. McDaniels comes in for Jason Terry. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Pablo Prigioni. Pocket 6. Here's Beverley. And it's off the back rim. No good. Bit of controversy, guys. Last season, Doc Rivers had the Lakers championship banners covered up for Clipper home games.
I thought it was a smart decision, Kevin. I mean, you got to make it your home gym, and all they did was hang up banners of their own players. A smart move by Doc, and the Clippers will.
Oh, look out! Oh.
Putting on a show for these people.
I cannot believe he pulled that one out in the course of an actual game. Are you kidding me?
I just want to point it if you got it, Buck.
They set the screen, and Davis can't get it to go.
Hey, the defense was right there, just waiting. Doing a nice job of anticipating that play.
Steve, every team needs tough interior defense to be successful.
27 seconds left to play in the first quarter. And Beverly gets to Monty Ewing. With his first shot attempt. Good! Monty Ewing has got his first bucket of the night.
Boy, that mid-range jumper is a beautiful thing to have in your bag. And they've had it going today.
Yeah, but look down at the other end of the court. That shot is not held true.
Boy, that's a warm-up jumper there. I mean, when you're a pro, you can't make excuses for missing that.
No good on the buzzer beater. And that can concludes the first quarter of play. Rockets lead by 6. And the second quarter will be on the way when we come back. In at the point. Patsy's out there for the Clippers. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, over to you.
Hey, Kevin. Coach Doc Rivers certainly hasn't minced words since joining the Clippers. He's held each player accountable and defined roles. He told DeAndre Jordan he wouldn't run any plays with him, that he just wanted them to focus on defense. Jordan said Doc knows how to reach people. There are egos on every team, and he knows how to control all of that.
Champion with the Celtics. He's one of the best coaches in the league. Thanks, Doris.
Wow, he was just wide open there. That's way too easy.
Paul kicks to Griffin. Out of bounds. Houston takes possession.
Well, that's inexcusable to throw a pass that far off the mark.
Rockets leading by 6.
Don't let him shoot!
Harden outside. And there's the pass to Beverly. Harden right shot. Rebound by the Clippers. Griffin's got his third rebound on the night. Paul kicks to Redick. It's stolen by Smith. And here's the break. Here's Ariza. Finishes the paint with a slam.
Boy, extremely opportunistic defense leading to those points there.
That dunk, Clark, coming within seconds of the steal.
Love the way they convert from defense to offense.
So that's what happens when you get all 5 guys on a string defensively, ready to react and make a play.
The shot's good from Jordan. Second quarter, we're a little over a minute and a half in. Beverly kicks to Harden. Feeds it to Beverly. Kicks it out to Ariza. Harden outside. Howard trying to free himself. And Harden with the basket on the assist by Ariza. 16 points for James Harden. Clippers trailed by 9. Trevor Ariza last season with perhaps the best campaign steal in his 10-year career.
Yeah, he played starters minutes, shot a career-high 3-point percentage. I think a lot of it, Kevin, was just the combination. And then also John Wall's emergence as a great point guard. Ariza had a lot of open looks.
And the foul called on Blake Griffin. That is his first foul of the game. Houston leading by 9. Harden outside. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2.
You could say that Ariza was in a contract here, looking for a new contract, playing for a new contract. He's up his 3-point percentage for 3 straight seasons. It seems he's put in the work to really solidify that part of his game.
And Ariza has always been great shooting 3s from the corner. He's quite a bit. Last season, the highest total of 3-8 in his career. Clippers need to do a better job guarding against Harden.
18 points. He's done a little bit of work behind the arc. Got a pair of 3-pointers.
Well, the defenders have that in the back of their minds now, too. So they're going to close out on him quicker. It should allow him to use the drive if he wants.
Terrence Jones has checked in for Houston. Mantiunas comes in for Smith. That one's in there. The lead is cut to just 9 points on the basket from Blake Griffin. It's Harden with the drive. A rim-rattling two-handed jam.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Well, they already have him staggered, and now all of a sudden they're throwing some haymakers.
Here's Redick. Griffin shot is off.
And they forced the miss with that good defensive rotation. They're playing well together as a unit.
Kicks to Mantiunas. Some nice passing there by Houston. 6 to shoot. Here's Harden. The shot no good. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. Barnes dishes to Paul. And he lobs it up with the rim and the slam by Blake Griffin.
Maybe that'll ignite. I mean, impossible not to get pumped up after that. At least I think that would be the case.
Well, you can see the immediate reaction of the guys on the bench. They are. Look at them. They are pumped up.
Yeah, they're geeky. That's what those alley-oops do, though.
Dishes to Paul. Outside, Griffin. Adeunis grabs the miss. Adeunis has got 3 rebounds now in this one. Reza passes to Beverly. Adeunis dishes to Hart. There's the pick. Jones gets to Adeunis. Harden outside. 6 to shoot. Pass to Beverly. Houston needs to get a shot. Here's Jones. Clippers grab the miss. Jordan's got 5 rebounds tonight. Ball gets to Redick. It's tipped. Griffin dishes the ball. 3-on-3. Harden outside. He kicks it to Beverly. And there's the feed to Ariza. By Houston.
He hit a 3 in the first, and so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
And Chris Paul picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Rockets leading by 9. There's the dish to Adeunis. He feeds it to Jones. Kicks to Beverly. In the corner, Harden, just 5 on the clock. Ariza goes in. Good, it's Harden with the assist that time. And that's now 7 points for Trevor Ariza.
Although they didn't end with the best record in the West, Clippers were one of the top teams against the West. They had a terrific in-conference record.
Harden kicks to Beverly. Dishes it to Jones. Good on the shot.
Nice, accurate pass right into the middle.
Clippers trail by 13. As you guys know, the Clippers did very well in the conference. 36 wins for them, which ties them with the Thunder, Steve, for the second best mark.
Well, you have to be able to dominate like that if you're going to win your division. And that's what the Clippers were able to do last season for the second straight year.
Houston making some changes. Brewer comes in for Jones. And it's Terry in for Patrick Beverly. Paul with the ball. And it's Harden picking him up. A shot by Jordan, no good. It's Harden with the drive. Tipped away. Paul with the steal. And here's the fast break. Shot is blocked. To the paint. It's deflected. Griffin with the steal. Here's a whistle. It's going to go on Corey Brewer. That's foul number 2 for him.
Boy, that's his second foul. He does not want to pick up number 3 here. That'll mess your game up for sure.
A tripod ball.
Boy, his struggles continue here in the second quarter.
Can't hit from in close. Now, here is Harden. 20 points for him. Brewer passes it to Terry. Outside. Shot clock at 5. Another miss by Houston. Clippers drilled by 13. Barnes dishes to Griffin. Blocked. Ball against Terry. Here's Harden on the wing. Harden draws the double. Pass to Terry. Front pass the arc. The miss, and Los Angeles guys are shooting 33% in the second quarter. The offense is looking crossed up and confused at times.
Boy, the prettiest play in basketball to me. Execute it to perfection.
I don't think we're going to get an argument there. Everybody loves the alley-oop.
Well, unless you're the team getting dunked on, of course.
Harden against Paul. Terry gets to a reason. It's a nice Nice passing there by Houston. There's the triple. Brewer. Good. Brewer's got 10 points in the game.
Seems like guarding him on the perimeter is not a priority for this defense, but it will become one if he continues to knock them down.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a back.
And that one's good.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
It's a strategy that has served them well in this opening half, Mark.
And Houston calls their first time out of the game.
Well, Chris Paul breaking Magic Johnson's record last season. 13 double-doubles to start the season. That's points and assists we're talking about. Now, anytime you're mentioned in the same breath as a Hall of Famer, that's a pretty good thing.
And it's a completely new group for Los Angeles. And then for Houston, Howard comes in for Trevor Ariza. And it's Pablo Prigioni in for James Harden.
Nothing seems to be going down for him today.
Turkoglu passes to Crawford. Rivers kicks to Davis. And the layup's good off the glass. Davis has got his first points of the game. And Chris Paul finishing last season as the NBA's leader in assists per game. His third time achieving that mark.
And he's been in the top five in the category pretty much since he came into the league. You won't find any better than Chris Paul.
Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burns. Doris, what do you have?
Well, gentlemen, if you ask Coach Doc Rivers about DeAndre Jordan, he's going to say something along the lines of, he can single-handedly change a game with his defense. I genuinely see traits of Bill Russell. Jordan said, to be compared to somebody like that, I take it to heart. Defense is my first, second, and third priority. I know that Doc can still bet it.
There's greatness and respect to be had doing the dirty work, Doris. Thank you. Pause. Dishes to Crawford. And it's rejected. Here's Brewer. 10 points for him. High post try. Pause with the rebound.
And his mechanics are just all out of whack now. He just has no feel for his shot.
Well, his numbers certainly back that fact up. Cold here.
Seems like they're on their heels every time defensively because the ball continues to go into the post.
Well, if they don't pick up the aggression, things are only going to get worse.
Prigioni passes to two. And Prigioni kicks to two. Passes it to Prigioni. Another miss by Houston. Trailed by eight. Rivers with it. Davis sets a screen. Rivers dishes to Davis. And the rebound goes to Jason Terry. Terry's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Howard setting the pick for Terry. Tries to snap the cold streak. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. With the ball. Guarded now by Jason Terry. A quick look, no good that time.
Well, I think it kind of alligator arm that short stroke. After doing a nice job to get open, he didn't finish the shot.
Turkoglu kicks to Hahn. A great 1-2 punch. Beautiful pass.
Well, this is how you completely rattle the opponent's rhythm.
And for such terrific on the ball defense to trigger the transition opportunity.
And it wasn't just a tough move, it was the exclamation point they put on the fast break with the slam.
Houston making a switch. McDaniels checked in. Here's Prigioni. Now a timeout called by Houston. Houston with a big group substitution here. Checked in for Monte Yunus. Pisa comes in for Corey Brewer. James Harden is checked in for McDaniels. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Pablo Prigioni. Harden draws the double. Ariza has the open look. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Harden's got his 7th assist of the game with that last one. Here's Hawes. He's it up and in off the pretty assist. Got his 3rd basket of the night.
What a beautiful assist. That's a couple of teammates clearly on the same page.
Smith with a screen on Crawford. Smith outside. Off target from outside. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game. And there's the call on Austin Rivers. That's his first foul. Los Angeles now. 7-point differential. Here's Crawford. Goes to the reverse layup and pops it in. Crawford's got his first bucket in this one.
And he shows us he knows how to finish with a flourish.
From deep, Harden got it off in time, but it's no good. And the first half ends in a close one. Houston on top. They're up by 5. And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Thank you, Kevin. Coach, with the foul trouble right now, do you plan on resting your starters and relying on your bench?
Well, we're going to have to, you know, so whether I have trust or not, and I do, they're going to play regardless.
Coach, thank you so much. Over to you guys.
All right, Doris, thank you, and stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter underway. Harden.
Yeah, he was on a mission there in the first half, just trying to get into the lane every time possible.
Aggressive attacking basketball at its very best.
We've got a moment left on the floor, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up for the second half. So on the floor for Houston, Beverly and Harden man the back. Trevor Ariza out there with Smith. And it's Howard in at the 5, roaming the paint. Griffin sets the screen for Paul. The pass to Griffin. Here's Reddick, back to Griffin. Here's Jordan, and good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points.
I don't know what's happening to their defense. I mean, they don't have any effort, any purpose.
And it's really costing them. I mean, the last 5 baskets at that end have been on very easy looks.
It's Harden with the drive.
Are an emerging factor in the West. Not 100% sold on them being championship caliber. I still think you got to give that front office a lot of credit in terms of what they got out of the superstar tandem, Harden and Howard. I think it's a strong foundation of scoring and defense.
Here's Harden on the wing, covered by Reddick. Harden left side. Again, and counting, the shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
He got a great read of where that miss was going. That allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
Rockets have hit 6 free throws in 10 attempts.
Well, last season they only hit 71% of the free throws, so this is a continuing problem, guys.
Yeah, as a group, really a dismal year for them from the line last season.
Griffin trying to get open. Offensive rebound. Break there, shot after shot, they couldn't get anything to fall.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of them.
Harden missing again. The Rockets came out smelling like a rose, didn't they? Bringing in Howard, but some luck along the way, too. You remember the Chris Paul Lakers trade?
Rockets would have gotten Paul Gasol on the deal.
And then not Dwight Howard because they wouldn't have had the capital to absorb him. So, you know, they're probably glad that in hindsight that deal fell through because Dwight Howard, the younger and more talented player, when you think about his comparison to Gasol.
Smith, that's the pick for Harden. Shot clock at 6. High post shot. Another miss by Houston.
You've got to like what they've been doing down there in the low post part.
I do. I love it. Their rebounding has been outstanding. So important in a tight game.
And it's Paul penetrating. It'll go. The Rocket lead is cut down to just 3 on the basket from Jordan.
A delicious dime from Chris Paul there.
Harden outside. Screened by Howard. Pass to Ariza. Harden outside. A floater. That is good. Harden's got 23.
You know, that's one way he can finish, but not the only way. He's got a lot of tricks up his sleeve.
And the Clippers call time here.
Well, he's watching his club miss a lot of shots that they normally make, and that has to be frustrating. So, I think he's going to call this timeout just to try to see if they can be more aggressive, get them to the free throw line.
Sometimes that's the best solution for them, but ultimately I think they'll be able to shoot themselves out this month. But in the meantime, maybe get into the free throw line and help.
Catching up on the changes for Houston. Monty Unis is checked in for Howard. And Corey Brewer's subbed in for Josh Smith. It's tipped. Point Rocket lead.
Large part of what they've been able to do here is centered around his offense.
A moment to check in with Doris Brooks. Doris.
Kevin, Doc Rivers was just addressing the plan with his team. The most important points they can get, he said, are points in transition. He told them to push it, create opportunities on the fast break. He also said that he loved their matchups in the low post and told his guys get the ball into the post whenever they can. There's still plenty of basketball left to play.
Thank you, Doris. Redick dishes to Jordan. Now, Redick. Paul outside. Griffin takes to Jordan. Kicks it out to Paul. From deep. Brewer grabs the board. Brewer's got his 3rd rebound on the night. Harden, no good.
If they could end every possession with that shot, they'd be happy. 10, that's an easy layup.
Ball kicks to Griffin. It's tipped. Monty Unis with the steal. Oh, and a fast break for the Rockets. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The hustle stats for the Rockets.
Defensively, they've played high energy level, guys. And all the steals we've seen, really a result of that aggressiveness.
You know, adding to that, Steve, you look at their block totals tonight, and you see how feisty they've been on the defensive end this game.
And stolen by Ariza. And here we go. Harden, head to the hoop. Rips down the breakaway slam.
Agility leads to thievery there as he's got his hand in there to get the steal. Intelligent play to immediately start the break.
Plays like that are telling the story of this game for me so far. To hand over any more easy points like that.
There's a whistle. It's going to go in 4-3. That's his 3rd foul of the game. And it's the Clippers with the ball. Down by 12. Offensive rebound. And oh, there's a whistle. He was going up for a layup. And while it looked like there was some contact, I wasn't sure they were going to call a foul shot or not, but sure enough they have. So he'll head to the free throw line. Daniels, he's checked in for the Rockets. Ariza sets a screen for Harden. Kicks to Beverly. 3-pointer. Shot misses. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. It's tipped. Stolen by McDaniels. To the inside. On the jam by Monty Unis.
Oh, an
kind of moments you love to see. Excellent defense leading to a dunk at the other end.
Clark, you got to marvel at the transition game when they've got it clicking. It's really explosive.
High octane for sure.
Oof. Turning defensive pressure into offensive opportunities. That's what it's all about.
Dishes it directly. Six on the shot clock.
Boy, I tell you what, the complexion of this game would be completely different if he shot the ball anything like he's capable. He almost got to that shot in time, but not quite. You can't touch the ball once it's on the way down.
Jamal Crawford, he's checked in for the Clippers. Ball kicks to Griffin. Back the ball. By Harden, and pushing it up is Houston Rockets again in transition.
I think that play sort of sums up what we've seen throughout, just simply being outplayed both sides of the ball. Smart basketball defensively turning into quick points.
And that's not going to be able to continue if they hope to get back into this game. Deflating play for your morale.
To the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter.
Pass to Beverly, jacks up a three, and it's the Clippers with the rebound. Griffin's got 9 rebounds in the game, getting it done.
Blake Griffin, arguably the top posterizer in the game. Opponents don't like being embarrassed, and they'll take a hard foul on him if need be. Some have said that Griffin needs to retaliate for his own well-being. Go back at some of those.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Davis has checked in for DeAndre Jordan. Turkoglu comes in for Barnes. And it's Austin Rivers in for Chris Paul. Pablo Prigioni is checked in for Houston. Got a piece of it. Crawford with the steal. And now here's Rivers, the fast break opportunity. And finished off by Griffin.
Advantage of shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Rockets leading by 11. Now here's Beverly. He kicks it to Prigioni. Another miss by Houston.
You know, normally when you dominate on the glass, it really shows up on the scoreboard, but not so much here today.
You're right, Steve. Typically it is a good barometer that indicates who's winning, but not so.
Beverly. He's guarded by Rivers. Here's Monty Unis. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. Davis has got his third rebound tonight. Turkoglu inside the line. Again, the Clippers.
That's another assist for a team that is putting on the clinic on how to share the ball.
I just love the mentality. The shot isn't there. They're not forcing anything. They're moving it side to side.
Daniels gets to Ariza. Ariza, a screen on Rivers. Shot clock at 6. Here's Beverly. And too long on the shot.
He just has not been able to get into that groove yet, guys. But as a whole, it hasn't affected him too much.
Offensive rebound.
Excellent interior defense there. Good rotations.
No doubt about it, Steve. He's a real presence inside. Takes up a lot of space.
Houston moving it around. He only passes to Beverly. Another miss, and they've really hit a rough patch here.
His touch has disappeared on him this quarter. He just hasn't been able to get it going.
Rivers kicks to Davis. Shoots from 14. Jump shot is good. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back. Timeout called by Houston. And during the timeout, both coaches get a chance here to review the strategy at this point of the game along
some rehydration going on with Gatorade. Everyone trying to bring their top game here tonight.
Yeah, that's why you see the trainers going around to every player, making sure they're hydrated, they're getting enough to drink during the game. It's so important. Hydrate yourself, keep yourself strong and ready to play for these big minutes down the stretch.
Sets the screen for Crawford, and the foul called on Jamal Crawford. That is his first foul of the game.
This game is going to get even more out of hand unless they stop coughing the ball up.
Yeah, it's been a forgettable quarter for them. Terrible ball handling.
Smith with a screen on Crawford. Harden makes a big hype pounce and goes in. Harden's got 14 points now in the second half.
What a top-notch game he's had. He's gotten them in front, and it sure seemed like he's going to keep them there. All by himself, it looks like.
Davis down low, covered by Smith. That's good. The Houston Rockets have back down to 7. The bucket there from Davis.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Yeah, that's 5 of their last 6 baskets inside the lane. They have really established themselves inside.
Howard setting the pick for Harden. Screen by Howard. The feed to Brehiani. No good on the 3. Now Griffin. He's got 14. And the wing jumper off line. And that's going to do it for the third quarter. Rockets lead by 7. Of the game.
This was an exceptional pass, guys, and we see the result. Hits him in stride, and bam, the slam dunk.
Rockets leading by 7. CP3 at point with Redick near the back. DeAndre Jordan is out there with Spencer Hawes, and it's Barnes at the small forward. That's who's out there for the Clippers.
Nothing fancy about that play. It's good, hard-nosed basketball, but all in the board.
Here's Redick. So he earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact, and he'll shoot 2.
J.J. Redick, acquired by the Clippers going into last season. Great fit, but injuries really held him back. First surgery to repair ligaments in his wrist, then a bulged disc in his lower back. Ended up playing just 35 games in the regular season.
And go free throws good for Redick. And Redick, were not for the injury, was on pace, Clark, for the best season of his 8-year NBA career.
Kevin would have been a career high in points per game. Great efficiency for Redick as well. He flourished playing alongside former ACC rival CP3, Chris Paul.
Shot clock at 6. Harden against Paul. Ariza has the open look. That 3 off the mark. Clippers trailed by 5. Screen on Harden. He lobs up the alley-oop pass. Here's Paul. To the left side wing. 11 feet away. And it comes off the front of the rim. Rockets leading by 5. Ariza dishes to Harden. Harden draws the double. Ariza goes in. And it's good. Gets the shot, he'll go to the free throw line.
Terrific play right there. Great strength to finish through the hit.
That's how you do it, the bump and the bucket.
Brewer is checked in for the Rockets.
The Rockets, of course, at the forefront or vanguard as far as advanced analytics. Some in the NBA have stopped. They're doing something right.
Paul kicks to Hawes. From the corner, misses off the right iron. For Houston, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Harden outside. Smith sets the pick for Harden. Here's the dish to Brewer. He feeds it to Howard. And he dunks it down.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And hammering down with with the two-handed slam.
Well, they already had him staggered, and now all of a sudden they're throwing some haymakers.
And as you guys know, the Rockets at the forefront technology-wise, too. You see coaches with electronic tablets.
Well, they installed flat-screen monitors in the locker room, highlighting stats and videos for players. So, you know, they're trying to close the loop and create that line of communication between the numbers crunchers and the players themselves.
Here's Reddick, deflected by Brewer. Harden has a wide-open look. Howard, soft touch of the box. And now it's a 12-point Rocket lead.
They have to box out better than that. And that putback is just another example of the difference between these two teams today.
Reddick is in the corner. They need this. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got his 8th assist here tonight. Rockets leading by 9. About 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Howard with a screen on Paul. Harden kicks to Howard. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. It's on Spencer Hawkins.
Dwight Howard has played 6 straight All-Star games until last season. The new balloting system with 2 backcourt players and 3 frontcourt players resulted in Blake Griffin and Kevin Love in the starting line. Howard felt slighted.
To get through, and he just ducked in for the layup. Terrific job.
Harden against Paul. It's Ariza on the wing. Back to Harden. From past the arc, and that one's good. Harden's got 17 points here in the second half.
Yeah, that's his first 3 of the half. There may be more in store.
Chin shot. Misses off the left iron. Clippers trailed by 9. But it passes to Griffin. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession.
Yeah, so close to picking that pass off, guys.
At least he got a hand on it. He did what he needed to do to make sure it didn't hit the target.
Now, here's Reddick, covered by Brewer. Shot clock at 6. Reddick pushes to Griffin. Blocked. Here's Jordan.
No, even though he's bite-sized compared to the big man on the floor, he's done some really tall work on the board.
Harden against Paul. Harden gets to Smith. Houston moving it around. And stolen by Jordan. Now the Clippers moving it up. Paul, the ball.
Finish.
Rockets leading by 7. And with it. Howard setting the bid for Harden. Just 4 to shoot. Misses from close range.
The defense was ready for him that time, and they had to be. He is so powerful in the lane. Boy, just a brain cramp, guys. I mean, that should have been the simplest of exchanges.
And so it's Houston with it. Howard with a screen on call. Here's Harden. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here. Well, you have to think of the Clippers as being an updated version of Showtime. They know how to drive down and get a win, too.
Yeah, I thought they were a little better defensively. They have guys that give you highlight reel material. But they're smart in how they attack teams and how they finish games, too.
Griffin sets the screen for Paul. That's a 2 from Barnes. Good, and Paul gets the assist. 14 points for Barnes.
They can't afford to give him that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to fight over the top of that.
shoot. And Howard with the stop.
You know, for a player with his explosiveness, that was ATM time. Cash money, the easy way.
Yeah, that kind of defense is not going to cut it against him.
Cash money. I like that, Clark. And with the Clippers, I think a big part of how they can line out a win if need be is that they know how to get to the free throw.
Side in the corner, Harden, and the rebound goes to Griffin. Griffin's got 11 rebounds in the game.
Well, one way or another, the Clippers, as you said, they'll find ways to score points, even if it means selling all or two. Do what you need to do to get wins, and most players are open to that.
Smith sets the pick for Harden. The wing, Brewer kicks it out to Harden. Screen by Smith. Oh, good with the triple.
He has just disappeared this quarter, not making a mark at all offensively.
I'm sure he's ready to put this quarter behind.